This is Mission Control Houston. We want to welcome you to today's Space Station Live. It is Tuesday, August 27th, 2013. The crew's very busy on board the space station today. The biggest news of the day is that Luca Parmitano and Chris Cassidy have been working on that troublesome spacesuit that Luca Parmitano was wearing back on July 16th. You're taking a look at pretty much what Luca Parmitano had seen during that eventful spacewalk that lasted 1 hour and 32 minutes. What the crew has been doing today is basically powering up the spacesuit, almost as if they were about to conduct another spacewalk. Obviously, Luca's not inside the suit this time, but they did verify that this water problem with this water coming up into the helmet still does exist. This is important because as the ground teams and the crew on board attempt to recreate this problem, they want to make sure, obviously, that the problem is still there. The investigation does continue into this spacesuit on two different fronts. The engineering teams are taking a look at the root cause. They're going to have the crew begin to manipulate this suit and to take some of the parts out that will be returned to Earth for investigation. But they needed to verify that this problem did exist before they do that, so sort of form a baseline so that anything they do to the suit in the future, any changes they do make, they know whether those will work or not. So again, you're seeing some of this water come up into this spacesuit helmet. This is very similar to what Luca Parmitano did experience back on July 16th as he and Chris Cassidy stepped outside for this spacewalk that was due to last about 6.5-7 hours. It was cut short down to 1 hour and 32 minutes whenever Luca did feel this water coming up back behind his head. Of course, that is not something that you want to have happen while you're out doing a spacewalk, so he and Chris did cut the spacewalk short. While this activity has been taking place, Kara Nyberg has been busy as well working on the experiment known as Spheres. You've seen it quite a bit here on NASA television throughout these expeditions on board the space station. Looks like something out of a movie, but these are basically free-flying satellites or pods that are designed to test out formation flying on board the International Space Station. This particular Spheres experiment, which is called Spheres Rings, looks a little bit different. It is run out of DARPA and the University of Maryland. And what it attempts to do is not only test formation flying, but also whether these two little mini satellites or three mini satellites could transfer power between them. Which, of course, has direct implications to bigger satellites that could be up in orbit. So that activity will continue throughout Karen's afternoon. Luca Parmitano himself has been working not only on that troublesome spacesuit with Chris Cassidy, but he's been working on something that is called In Space 3. This is an experiment that takes a look at something called colloids. These are sort of particles that are suspended in liquids. There's different forms of this experiment on board the International Space Station, but it has direct implications to life here on Earth, because these particles that are in these fluids change properties whenever a magnetic field is applied to it. They actually solidify, and the liquid can change. Now, what that means for us here on Earth is that this particular type of colloid or liquid could be used in brake systems. It could be used in buildings and bridges to make them more earthquake-proof, or things such as that, and also robotics. So this In Space 3 will continue throughout Luca's afternoon. The crew also has several different crew Earth observation opportunities today. They're going to be passing over Tanzania. They will also be taking a look at some of the flooding that is occurring in eastern Russia. This is considered some of the worst flooding in almost 100 years. There's more than 32,000 people that are being affected by it. The Amur River has actually broken its banks and is currently overflowing, so they will take a look at that. There's also some wildfires taking place over the United States, and some of the smoke plumes should be visible from the crew. They did capture some images of that yesterday, so if you haven't seen those, just log on to nasa.gov/station and take a look at them. And of course, you can always take a look at all of the rest of the crew Earth observations by visiting the NASA website to take a look at all the imagery that the crews have captured throughout their times on orbit. Finally, a programming reminder for tomorrow. We will have a crew news conference from here at the Johnson Space Center. That'll be Expedition 38 and 39. That'll begin at 1 p.m. Central Time, 2 p.m. Eastern Time. The crew will be talking to various traditional and social media members here at the Johnson Space Center about what to expect as they get ready to launch coming up toward the end of the year. Again, that Expedition 38-39 crew news conference coming up on NASA television tomorrow at 1 p.m. Central Time, 2 p.m. Eastern Time.